That sums it up. Sums it up.
You're gonna rock it.
Oh, I thought you were gonna flip around and see the scenery because it's so beautiful.
But it is. But you're much more beautiful than any. You have the. I better.
What?
You have the grandest canyon.
So close, Circus. Close, Circus. Close, Circus.
Let's do it! brothers and sisters, I got some bragging rights real quick. Now, Shorty here, he was just contacted a few days ago by Ripley's. Now, I just told you, he's going to be in the brand new book coming out this month. Well, now they've taken it a step further, and they're going to cast his body, and they're going to make the wax figures, and it's going to be in Ripley's all over the world. Right there, my little brother. He's my half-brother. Yeah! That's right, baby.
This one hurts. Ladies and gentlemen, that's two. Come on! Now two cowbells pulls my face down a little bit more. It pulls my eyes down a little bit more. Makes it look as though I'm melting. And a lot of people walk away from the show thinking that I must be sick. I'll be honest with you. I am sick. I got a fever. This is an old antique cowbell. This one's heavy. This one hurts. This one might rip my eyelids again. Ladies and gentlemen, it's three. I do this day after day. I do it night after night. And as the years go on, it's going to begin to take its toll on my eyes and on my nose. In fact, my grandmother often asks me, what are you going to do when you're an old man? I tell her, I'm going to scare my fucking grandchildren. I can't see anything at this point, but I can feel there's a little more room. One more time, not just the trunks. Do you know what this trick needs? Wrong. It needs a bowling ball. This bowling ball weighs 10 pounds. Watch the difference on my eyes and my nose. I can't do this very long. So get ready to club! Get it off, get it off, get it off! Wait for it, wait for it, wait for it. That's hook number one! Hook number two! Stay in school. Hook number three, come on!
Are you familiar with razor blades?
Oh yeah.
Carlos is familiar with razor blades. No, I had an itch, I had an itch. It's not because his name's Carlos. No, I didn't. Anyway, so Carlos, are you familiar? Carlos, stick a finger up in the air. That's what, I'm used to that one, but that's cool. Well, that one, you're like this. But if you're Carlos, it's more like that. Yeah, okay, all right, sorry. What you're gonna do, Carlos, is right now, you're gonna generally, just be cool about it, you're gonna check out each razor blade. Please make sure they're neat, solid, stainless steel razor blades. Just it's a liability thing, I have to say it. Don't be an idiot, Carlos, and run your fingers along the razor blades to examine them. I don't think I can explain why, but you never know, because we're at a bar. There's alcohol here, and people kind of are having a good time. Little sippy sips, I'm guessing, right? So, Carlos, just check them out, make sure they're real. Please be gentle, please be careful, but they aren't real. Just don't, accidentally, like, cut yourself! I'm a tip. But make sure they're real. I'll be honest, the apple is fake, because I don't feel like buying a fucking apple every time I do a magic show. Because we like to say fuck in this show. So there you go. Carlos, they're good. They're real. Thank you, Carlos. You're a good sport. Now, in case you didn't see Carlos check out the razor blades, they're real. Or maybe you saw it and you don't believe Carlos, because why would you? Nobody knows Carlos. I don't know. So I also brought with a little piece of paper that I'm going to slice and dice with each razor blade so you can see exactly how sharp they are. Because since I cannot hand out apples with razor blades in them for all the little trick-or-treaters to eat, I save them for me and I eat them instead.
Thank you.
do here, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to take this household screwdriver and I'm going to shove it into the center of my skull. The question is, do you want to see it? Do you want to see it? Now, before I do this, safety first. Always use protection. Here we go.
In my mouth, out my nose. At home, I call this trick foreplay. There you go. This one's got a bit of a spray factor to it. Aren't you glad you sat up close? You want me, don't you? Yeah, I can tell. Here, check it out. Does this do anything for you? You felt the tingle in a minute, Here, grab it. Pull. That's yours, you can keep that.
Skeptics. All right, motherfuckers. I have something for you skeptics. In the shape of a power drill with a 5-inch drill bit. That is 5 inches, right? You know that, wouldn't you? I'm just kidding, man, This is known as the homemade lobotomy. Thrills, chills, and sometimes Dr. Bills. Now you gotta lick it before you stick it. Here we go.
Sharpened on one end with a handle on the other side. Some of you are already looking at me going, where the fuck is he gonna stick that? I've done this trick on The Tonight Show with Jay Leno. I've done it on Stan Lee's Superhumans. And tonight, I'm doing it on mushrooms. Yeah! That'll be fun. the nose kick in. It's a little bit weird. It's a little bit sick. I call it the human meathead.
Hey there, fancy pants. Play the songs and make us dance. Play the tunes and make the ladies swoon. A song for all the lovely knots, shallow dreams and broken hearts. Feels like sunny days are coming soon. Hey, Mr. Welcome, spin the wheel and trail the starlight shining bright tonight on you. Do a dance from way back when. Tonight's the night when all your dreams come true.
The eyes, are you ready? Are you ready? Watch. Stupid chicken stuff. That's right. Now, ladies and gentlemen, he's going to amaze and amuse you. Confound and confuse your ways most would deem humanly impossible. Brothers and sisters, please welcome back Mr. Dan Sperry.
Dude, chicken soup doing something pretty fucking badass. Maybe go to the bar now?
I'll never forget. forget the moment we kissed the night of the hayride. The way that we hugged to try to keep warm while taking the sleigh ride back.
It's not punk rock or less, but I tried to undress that lifesaver as fucking sexy as I could. You into it? Oh, hey, by the way, hi VIP people up there. You guys are all right. You having a good time? Yeah, all right. Good talk.
The Saturday dance, I got up the nerve to send you some flowers and bags.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's an ancient ritual that was performed in India over 1,000 years ago. The question is, do you want to see it? Do you want to see it? Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back right here, Miss Vivian Olivia. We'll be right back.
Let's do it. Take a look at my left hand. Am I wearing any protection? Am I wearing any protection? Am I cut? Am I bleeding in any way? Alright. How about my right hand? Any protection? Am I cut? Am I bleeding in any way? Well, stick around. I might be before done. Thanks a lot. Was kind of my idea. Now, before I step on this glass, I'm sure we can all agree, can't afford to lose any more appendages, right? Definitely these two. But more importantly, that one right there. What's that?
Yeah!
I am Shorty Dangerously. And I'm a bad, bad man! Ladies and gentlemen, this is Shorty Dangerously! The world's honoriest
husband. You're damn right.
That's right, he's still a big sister.
Hey, we matched on Tinder. Yeah,
uh-huh. Half-brother. That's like incest or something. That's fucked up. Alright. I tell you what, for the most dangerous stunt in the sideshow business, do you want to see it? Do you want to see it? Ladies and gentlemen, before your very eyes, this young man, he's going to take 27 inches of solid steel, and he's going to swallow it all the way down to the pit of the stomach. Ladies and gentlemen, here he comes, Mr. Ryan Stock.
All right, you guys, there he is. It is true. Sword swallows one of the most dangerous stunts in a sideshow, but here's the thing. There are less than 100 known sword swallowers in the world, and out of those 100 known sword swallowers, only 15 of them are known to be women. So tonight, representing the ladies tonight, we're bringing her back, the beautiful Vivian Oblivion. Now she's going to be taking this sword, she's going to be putting it into her mouth, she's going to slide it down her esophagus, it's going to go in between her lungs, it goes through her lower esophageal sphincter, yeah, her sphincter, it goes into the stomach. She has no gag reflex at all. You've said that before, I'm sure. That's fine. Now she's going to take it all the way down, check this out, she's going to lubricate it just like you do at home. Fuck you, we've all spit on it, dudes. It goes down her throat, check it out, all the way down, down the hatch, without a scratch. So why should I care about that reputation? Come on! Oh, look at that, you're a corpo. Yeah, you can take that. Now, if there are 15 known women in the world who can swallow a sword, we found out there are 5 known people in the world that can swallow a sword with a curve on it. When they say a curve, they mean a slight curve, like a saber or a katana blade. I got a sword here tonight that's got more than a slight curve on it. It's got nearly a 90 degree curve. Now, I can't jam this straight down my throat. It'd be coming out my side. That's right, mine's curved. And you said that before. Yeah. It's going all the way down. Now check it out. I have to match the curve of my body with the curve of the blade. Getting it all the way down. Here we go. He must suck a good dick. How do you suck a bad dick? You can't put the wrong end in your mouth, can you, dude? Nope. One way to do it. As I was working on this, I thought, wouldn't it be cool if I could swallow a sword from my right side while it was in my body, let go, twist it 180 degrees inside my body, pull it out on this side. I started working on this last year. Ripley's, believe it or not, made me as the first known person in the world ever to twist a curved sword in your body. I'm going to try it tonight. I don't know why I'm trying it, but I do know why I'm trying it. It's because I'm using my superpowers for good. Be the world's greatest drug mule. I could. You know how many balloons full of Mexican black tar heroin I could smuggle? 11. I'll tell you where we go. We're gonna bring back the beautiful Vivian Oblivion. She has something special. She brought along a song. Now this is dangerous. Each and every ridge of the saw she feels on its way down. The scrapes past the epiglottal folds and it pops. You know how that feels. No, you don't fucking know how that feels. Only Vivian knows how that feels. Check it out. Swallowing a saw. This is a saw. It's a saw. In fact, this This is a drill. Now here's the thing. Swallowing a running power drill is a difficult process. To get it down the throat, you actually have to have it running. It'll pull itself down my throat. I have to put it in reverse to get it back out. I'm pretty sure you're not going to see this again in your life, but there's a really good reason for that. Nobody likes to get drilled in the throat. Well, not nobody, but most people don't like to get drilled.
But yet he still lives to laugh and joke about it, ladies and gentlemen. One more time for Mr. Ryan. Stop. All right. And we got one more for you. The next thing you notice, ladies and gentlemen, of course, is going to be that. Coffin-like sarcophagus. It has the slits way up at the top and the bottom of the box. That's where I'll be placing 15 very large blades. Now these trapezoidal holes here, those are viewing holes. And they're viewing holes for each and every single one of you. The next thing you notice, ladies and gentlemen, is the performer come to the stage. She's the Indiana Twister. She's the Rubber Man Sister. Brothers and sisters, please welcome back one more time for Miss Vivian Oblivion. Vivian here, she fits oh so nicely. From the tip of her toes, all the way up to her pretty little face. Now I'm going to seal the box. Nullify any chance of escape. So keep a close eye. Say goodbye. All right, now I'm going to start with the three largest of the 15 blades. I'm going to take the first blade, and I'm going to cut the box directly in half. Now, much like the first blade, I'm going to take the second blade, and I'm going to cut the box in half on this side. Now for those of you up close, down low, and in the front row, you can see them as they go right through the top and right out the bottom of the box. But I still have many more blades to go. Now ladies and gentlemen, as I insert each and every one of these blades, that lovely lady, Miss Vivian Oblivion, she's still alive on the inside. And she's contorting her body like a snake or an octopus would wrap itself around its prey.
Wrap itself?
Wrap itself